Hey, bot builders. So you want to build a Streamlit app? Easy. You want to integrate a chatbot into your app? Also easy. You want to choose between LLM providers to power your chatbot? You want your bot to have customizable agentic flow? Not so easy. Until now. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a chatbot with a Streamlit front end. We'll make an API client for our bot that plugs right into Streamlit's chat elements. And I'll give you some pointers for customizing the bot with a visual drag and drop builder. Because simplicity and customizability shouldn't be a trade-off. So, without any further ado, let's dive in. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is build a bot. Now, if you create a new bot, this is exactly the workflow that you're going to get. This is my famous Winona wine sommelier bot, and all it does is give you advice about wine pairings or wines in general. We've got our chat bot. Now let's talk about integrating it into a Streamlit app. So here we have the guide for the chat API. It talks about basically how to access the exposed endpoint so you could interact with your bot. Because we can talk to it right now in the studio, but how do we interact with it from a different client? The answer is the chat API. So first things first, you have to install it. So what we're gonna do here is go back to our bot, scroll down to communication channels, and type in chat, and it's just down here. Now we install the integration. Cool. Now what we're gonna do is create a Python project where our Streamlit app and our client are gonna live. So I do this stuff in my dev directory. We'll call it Winona Streamlit. All right, so a couple things we have to do first. I'm gonna make a virtual environment, activate it. Now we want a .env file because to be able to interact with our API, we are going to need the end of the URL here. This is our key at the end. So chat API ID is right here. And let's just create a client file. Over here in the documentation, it says that you can make sure that the API endpoint is accessible by running a GET request to this endpoint here, the hello endpoint. So there we have it. We're gonna replace the webhook URL by the chat API key or API ID. Chat API ID should work, except single quotes. Okay, port request. You gotta install these dependencies first. We're gonna run a request just to that endpoint, and then we're gonna print the result. Great! And as you can see, it worked. It's saying hello to us. We're the BotPress user. So now, as we can see from the documentation, it exposes a lot of endpoints. And these are all basic endpoints pertaining to users, conversations, messages. And then if you want to get a little more fancy, there's participants. So that's when a conversation has multiple people involved. And events, you know, sending information, sending cards. So now that we know our API endpoint works, we want to create a client endpoint. I'm going to call it BotPress client. And what that's going to do is it's basically going to be the class that we interact with to be able to call our API calls. So we're going to make a base request method, and all the other methods are going to call this, all the other request methods. I'm going to set the URL to our base URI, and the end is going to be path. So for instance, when I make my create user function, I'm going to run on self.request. The method is going to be post, and we're going to put a slash before path. Wait, what is the path actually? Is it just users? Sweet. Okay, then we run the request and method, run it to the URL. Now we have to specify headers, and the headers are this right here. So we grab a response, and then in the event that there's a body, we add one. In this case, there isn't. It's actually called JSON, and we add the body. We check whether there's an error, and if it all works out, we return the response. Otherwise, we raise an error. Well, we don't raise an error, we just return it. You can obviously fix this to suit your needs. Cool. So now we want to be able to create a user. And this user will only be on the chat API. All the conversations that you create through this API, they won't exist globally within your bot. They're just gonna be part of the chat integration. So how do we do this? First things first, we gotta put in the user data. For this, we specify a name, which I think of as your name. In my case, it's Ben. and an ID, which I think of that more like a username. You're not gonna see it all the time the way you will with your name, so it's not as important to make it pretty. In this case, we pass that as the body to the function. And we wanna return the output to that, so what we're gonna do is create this user, and we're gonna see what happens. Let's just make that a main function at the bottom, because we're probably gonna need this again. This client, yeah, there's no arguments there. And I'm just gonna print the result here. Like I said, the name's Ben. The ID is also Ben today. All right, let's see what's up. Cool, we created a user. Now this is very important. We created the user, and this key here is the user key that we're gonna need to reference the user, which means how you actually deal with that in your app will depend on the architecture of your whole app. But for the time being, we wanna store this here in our configuration file, because we will need to reference it anytime we wanna, I don't know, start a new conversation or create a message. So we have this client, we have our user. Now let's talk about integrating it into a Streamlit app. So there's this page over here that talks about building a basic LLM chat app using Streamlit. If you go to the last section at the end, it talks you through using the OpenAI client to make a Streamlit chatbot. And what I wanted to do for this tutorial was essentially just adapt the code from here, but instead of using OpenAI as your provider, you can plug in your BotPress bot using the chat API. So, I mean, we can get rid of OpenAI because we're not going to need that. And let's import our own client. Cool. Now let's have a look at what this model does. So using our session state, what we do is we store the model name, which obviously is not a problem anymore. We have a list ready to store the messages, and we go through our messages and we add them to the chat. And then when we create a new message, we also add that to the chat. So this is where the bulk of the logic happens. What we're doing is we're creating a stream, and using that stream, we are sending messages to the bot, and we're grabbing the messages from the bot and rendering them to our chat interface. So how we're gonna deal with doing that in our app is what I'm gonna show you right now. So for starters, we're gonna create a new conversation. So that's just a simple post request. Now, this is one of those cases in this API where even if you have no content, you still have to give a body. We're just gonna give an empty body. Okay, we have the user key here in the environment variables file. And let's just add this to our headers. See if it works this time. Yeah, it was created. For the time being, we're just gonna keep it as a constant. The conversation, we're gonna be referencing one singular conversation. So we have our conversation, we have our user, obviously. Let's see what we can do about getting that into the app. When we send a new message, or what they're calling a prompt, we wanna actually create a new message. So we're gonna add a function in our client to do that. Now this takes a conversation ID parameter because the message has to pertain to a specific conversation. And then we want the message body, basically. This one has a payload. We're only gonna be working with text messages for this tutorial, but there's documentation you can read about how to do various types of media in your message. We also have to pass the conversation ID in the body, and then we just call a request. Cool, we created a message. Also, we wanna grab all the messages from the conversation that have happened already. So what we're gonna do is, when we first load the app, we want to list all the messages. So let's do that right now. Here, it's as simple as sending a GET request to the messages endpoint. So we're gonna do up top over here. So we list the messages. We will just make sure we reverse that list because it comes in the opposite order how we want to upload them. And in this section here, this is where they're going to get displayed. For the time being, we don't have a role key inside each message object. So we're going to get rid of that for now, just so that the messages will display, because I want to just kind of have a proof of concept going on here. Let's run it for now just to see how it looks. Oh, there are no messages because we haven't made any messages. So let's integrate the create message part into our app. When we create a new message, or when we write a message, we send it, want to then upload it. So yeah, we're adding this to the messages, and then we're actually sending it to the bot. And we want to be able to grab the response. Hello. Obviously, we do not have these functions because our client is not the OpenAI client. So we've got to fix that.
the API exposes a listen endpoint, and that uses server sent events to listen for incoming messages. So let's add that to our bot. We're going to call this function listen conversation for obvious reasons. And in this case, we're not going to be able to just call the request function unless we modify it, but we're not going to do that right now. Yeah, let's add the base URI to the class. Because I find that looks nicer and it's more modular. So then the endpoint that we use is conversations. We index it by conversation ID and we grab the messages. Now, you are going to have to install the SSE library. So we're going to print the events as they come in. Now let's see how this works. So for now, we're going to run listen conversation. Just to give you a sense of how it works, rock and roll. Cool. So we have that open. Split screen. How do I split screen? Oh, no. I wanted split terminal. Hey. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to send a message to the conversation, and we're going to see what happens with the event listener so we can parse out the structure that the events get sent in. So from client import everything. Cool. We're going to instantiate a BotPress client and then create message. The conversation. And we're going to say, hi. Why does that not work? Oh my God, wrong endpoint. Listen endpoint. I'm silly. Hey girl. Cool. So the message came in and it's showing that it's my message. Let's see what the bot answers. Okay, the bot's message came in. Let's make an outputs folder and try to get a closer look essentially at what the output looks like. So this is what it looks like. It's JSON. So we have the type key. This is just for any type of event that happens with the bot. We have this data key, which is what stores all the important information. We've got the ID. We've got the user ID, which is important because the user ID for the other message that came from user is Ben. We have this data key. And we have the payload with the type and the text. Sweet. So how do we apply that to our client? Well, let's keep the print statement there for now. First of all, we're getting all these pings. We kind of want to filter them out. So forget about it. Otherwise, let's parse the data. So we're loading it to JSON library. Oops, loads. And then we're accessing the data key. Now, we want two things for this message for now. We want the ID just to be able to keep track of unique messages. I think that's always good practice to pass that between modules. And we want the text, which is in the payload. So this function will return an iterator, which whenever a new message comes, it will yield the ID and the text inside the body of that message. Now, how do we apply that to our app? In this section is where we deal with the logic for handling messages coming in from the bot. So first of all, we create a response box. And we want to keep track of the ID of the last rendered message. We're going to want this stuff, but for now, let's just comment it out to see what we've made so far. Oops. Okay. Cool. So that's what we're getting here is this empty streamlet box because we set the assistant role, which is why the messages are getting formatted properly as user and assistant, but it's empty. All right, let's uncomment this. First of all, obviously we're getting rid of this OpenAI chat client function. Instead, we are treating our iterator like an iterator. So we're listening to the conversation and basically anytime there's a new event, grab the ID and decide whether it has already been rendered. And if not, then we update that, obviously. And then we fill the response with the text. Cool. And then we want to add it to our session state, right? We want to update our messages. So we're going to hand the messages. So yeah, let's check out what we've got. Okay, so when we list messages, let's see what the output looks like. We get a key called messages that holds an array where each message is embedded inside this text over here. One issue that we have, though, is that we don't have the isBot key that we had with the singular message, which is going to make things more complicated down the line. So what we're going to do is iterate through the messages, make sure we grab the relevant information. So let's index the key messages and reverse the list. So the text, like we said, is in the payload key. And we want to add that to the session state. See what we get just by doing that. Okay, cool. This is me talking to the bot. It looks like I'm having a breakdown when you look there. But they're not formatted the way it is when you add new text. Why is that? It's because of the role. You see, we're adding a role here, a role key and a content key, which is how Streamlit knows how to parse it and determine whether you're the bot or the user. So let's change that right now. As you can see in messages, we do not have the isBot key, which is unfortunate. Instead, we just have the user ID. The options for user ID are either, I mean, this user with this kind of random string, or Ben, which is the user ID that we made before. So my thought is that I would add to the client a get user key, which basically just grabs the user and checks out the ID. And then we determine whether a message is from the user or the bot, depending on whether the message has the same user ID as the user. The endpoint is users/me. Now in our app, what we want to do is grab the user, and then from the user, I'll spare you the time. This is how we get the ID. It's within the user key. And now that we know the ID from the message, we can determine the role. How that works is basically it's either user or assistant. So it's user if the user ID key within the message is the user ID we determined. Otherwise, it's the assistant. Now we got to make sure we actually add that role and text. Actually, it's the content. See what happens. That is worse. Okay, why is this happening? Because we now have to add the role. That is not better because we have to add the content. And there we go. Cool. So we can continue this conversation. A little bit more about one. Something crisp. See what happens. Okay, you're looking for something crisp. Green apple. Prefer white wines. I like sparkling wine. Okay, it works. Wonderful. So this is great and all, but you might be asking, why bother with writing all this code to be able to adapt the Streamlit app to a whole other bot platform? The answer is, as promised, customizability. So we have our bot here, and we started out with these instructions. And let's say we don't want to just have the bot rely on background knowledge about wine, and we want to give it specific wines. In my case, I have this wine table that we're treating as an inventory. So it comes with, you know, descriptions of these different wines, ratings, price. Now, if you don't have your own wine table already hooked up, it's easy to pass it. You create a new table just like that. And then you add the data by hitting import, and then you drag your CSV here. In my case, this wine data comes from a wine data set that I could totally link in the description. It's also in other videos. Now, adding it to the knowledge base. Let's say it wasn't in here. Pretend I didn't do this already. We have the option to add a knowledge source. In our case, it's a table. And you have to have already uploaded the table. If you forget, you'll remember when you don't see this option here. We add the table, and now it's accessible to the knowledge base. We want to make sure that we have this search knowledge card, which, by the way, comes here by default. And then make sure you add whatever information you need to the instructions. The big one for me is the guardrails here, where I talk about only referencing wines that are available in the knowledge base and not to go rogue or to speculate and be very clear and rigid about either this is a wine we have or this is not a wine we have. So to make sure it's usable, we got to publish it. Now, just for good measure, I want to be creating a new conversation. This is our conversation ID. We're going to be passing throughout the app. And then let's load it up again. Make sure our bot has, yes, it's been published. Okay. Hey, and let's see if it's properly referencing the knowledge base. What do you have that'll blow my in-laws away? Cool. Now we've got some options. Ooh, something expensive. Great. It looked at the knowledge base and it found these. It has the rating over here. It has the name. It has the price point. So it looks like it does what it wants. So this is a great use of a platform like BotPress to be able to perform RAG as easily as I just showed you. Anyway, that's everything. That is how you build a Streamlit front end for a customizable chatbot. Let me know in the comments if there's something else you'd like to see. For example, if you want to be able to toggle through conversations or create new ones in app. And until then, happy bot building.